Hi guys, it's Monika. I thought I would do a diet update video, and I'm going to try to answer some of the questions that I've received from a few of you. Anyways, you know, I just want to say that to me, diet, health and fitness, it's all such a personal thing in my opinion, because one diet can work fabulously for somebody and then just be horrible for someone else, just not work. I also believe, like skincare, that your body gets used to whatever you're doing. And sometimes you have to shake things up to get your body to respond. Just like your skin can get so used to what you're doing for skincare that you actually do have to shake it up to see changes again, or to get into that right mode again, if that kind of makes sense. So I've had these questions thrown at me on diet. Why have I stopped doing keto? And I thought, you know, I probably addressed that in my previous video when I did the collab, which I will link that video as well. But I have a history of yo-yo dieting, and I think I probably know my body better than, you know, anyone else does. So, and not to rehash a whole long, drawn-out diet story, I'm sure many of you have been the same place that I have been. I've been up and down, and every time I go down and I lose, when I fall off, when I get trapped back into doing things I shouldn't do, I have a hard time resetting myself. I have a hard time finding my motivation once I lose it. And then when I gain more and faster. So anyways, I did really well with keto. I did really well with keto for a, you know, short period of time, in the sense that, in my opinion, when you use the word keto, many people use it wrong. The ketogenic diet is very specific on what you can eat, how much of it you can eat. You count your macros, your macronutrients. You calculate that to your body. And in keto, packaged foods, fast food, Atkins bars, so many things like that are not keto approved. Substitute sugars, diet Coke, you know, diet tonic, not keto approved. So I was a pure keto person for a relatively short period of time. I don't know, maybe a year, you know. I mean, as pure as I could get. I found it to be very, very hard to be a true keto person. That said, I'm not good in the kitchen. I'm not a cook. I don't have a whole lot of an imagination when it comes to recipes. So the women that I know that do keto really well do a lot of that. They do a lot of meal prepping. They cook naturally on their own. They have a good imagination. They can follow recipes. They can do a whole lot of things that I can't do. So I'm not naysaying keto. I'm just saying, for me, it ultimately was too hard for me to follow. So I went from keto to low carb. I did low carb for a long time. And over the course of my keto, I lost a lot of weight. I did get sick at the end. I lost my gallbladder. I had a lumpectomy. I already talked about all of that. And then when I kind of recovered, I just stuck to a low-carb lifestyle. And my lifestyle is such that I never have, or very rarely, it's gonna have to be a treat, but in general, when I go grocery shopping, I go around the store. I don't go up and down the aisle so much. I don't buy rice. I don't buy pasta. I don't buy bread. I don't buy cereal. I don't buy oatmeal. I mean, oatmeal is a very rare thing, and my husband has it. So I go around the store. I literally do. I buy good protein, you know, fish, chicken. I do, when I'm gonna have my beef, I have to have ribeye. If I'm gonna have a steak, it's a ribeye. I'm spoiled. I do a lot of vegetables. I do a lot of high fiber fruits. So in my endeavor of the years that I have been low carbing, one thing that I realized is not every carb is a bad carb. And it isn't. So, and your body needs to have, my body needs to have a mixture of nutrients to feel good, to look good, to respond, to be active. And I found that denying myself all carbs but 20 grams, for me, not for you or anyone else, was too hard, too restrictive, and for me, it set me up for failure. Not only did I have some health ramifications, hair, other things that, you know, may or may not have been contributed to my diet, but I think played some role, at least in the hair. But anyways, I digress. I don't want to go into that part of it. But I, the most important thing for me, the thing that I have come to understand fully about myself, and it's sad that it took this many years, but the most important thing for me is the realization that calories for me do count. I have to monitor my total caloric intake. I just have to. And I have to monitor my output in that sense. Like, what am I, how many calories am I burning? And when I was pure keto, I never counted calories. And then when you get lazy, you end up overeating. You end up having too much fat, too much beef, too much protein. At least I did. And then when I was low carbing, strict low carbing, in the sense that I'd have 30, maybe 40 grams of carbohydrates a day, I wasn't really counting my calories. And so after a while, I stopped losing weight. I started to gain weight, even though I was still low carbing. And what happened was I wasn't mindful of the calories in, calories out. And it's gonna be a whole lot of you that I'm not gonna agree with me. This is probably a very controversial diet video in that sense. Why did I stop keto? You know, that's my reasons. I still low carb, but if you put me next to a person that is a true low carber, they're gonna say I have too many carbohydrates. I probably do. And with my current diet program that I'm on, I do a 2-day deep cleanse where I don't eat. I mean, it's like a 2-day fast, and I have small little nutrients that I'm allowed to have during that 2-day period. And then I have so far switched it up with 2 meal replacements a day. I'll tell you, I feel fabulous. If I want to get rid of a bloat, if I overate on something, if I was bad, I just know the next day I can make a tweak to my diet and I can get right back on program. And I personally, for me, I love it. I started my new diet, which is a combination of the low carb. I still have very low carb. No bread, no pasta, nothing like that in the house. No white stuff, no flour. But I do have fruits. Mostly they are strawberries, blackberries, blueberries, raspberries, berries. But in the season, I'm an apple fanatic. Honeycrisp apples. I had Honeycrisp apple today. Once they go by and I can't get any more fresh apples, I won't have them. So in the summertime or late summer, when the corn is fresh, I'm a corn snob. I have to have corn on the cob. I can't eat canned corn or frozen corn, but fresh corn on the cob grilled on my barbecue grill, perfect. So I do have more carbs than a traditional low carber would allow. However, I think in general, my carbs are, you know, on some days, they could be as low as 40 and as high as 90 on some days. And then when I have a really bad cheat day, they're much higher. So when I started doing the meal replacements, and that's not for everybody either, you know, and it's not, it's something that even when I get to the point where I'm at, like where I'm at, I can do one meal a day. And then if I have to, I just reset myself. But currently doing a 2-day cleanse every month seems to be my magic pill, I guess, if you want to call it that. I cannot tell you how good I feel. And I've lost just about right now, since the end of June, about 24 pounds. And it's kind of a slow loss, but I love it. I love it. So keto just didn't work for me long term. I respect anyone that does keto. I think it's great, but I still believe fully in my heart, you'll never convince me otherwise, that still calories in and calories out. You have to monitor that. You have to really be aware of that. I had my blood work done last year when I wasn't on my meal replacement, when I was just trying to low carb and still high fat and all that. My blood work this year compared to last year is phenomenal. Phenomenal. I am excellent in every range that my doctor just couldn't believe it. So, you know, knock on wood that stays that way, but And at this point in time, I'm cresting onto 25 pounds since the end of June. I've been on two vacations. I've been to a convention in Boston. I've not felt deprived. I've had my cheats. I go out on a date night. I live a good, happy, balanced life. I can eat an apple. I could go have a corn on the cob. I can have fruit. I can have things that I normally, when I was keto, I would never have, or when I was strict low carb, I wouldn't have. So, but everyone's at a different phase in their life, and this is where I'm at now. This is my diet update. I love, love, love what I do. Is it cheap and free? No, but I also know me, which might not apply to you. When I have some skin in the game, I work really hard at it. You know what I mean by skin in the game? I mean, I pay for products. I pay for meal replacement. I love the ingredients. I love the balance of it. I pay for all that. So when it's just like when you go to a training program, and I struggle with this at work. I put on a training program, it's free. I have some people that will just blow it off because they have no skin in the game. So when you pay for something, I believe you work really hard at it. I want to make this go. I find that this lifestyle that I'm living, my diet, if you want to call it that, is a super wicked easy lifestyle for me. Super wicked easy, really. And I know now I sound like I'm a Boston East Coaster. Well, I am, guys. Wicked, wicked. But yeah, it is really super easy, and it is something I can live with, and I'm happy. Happy with my results. I really am. And I'm going to try to do these regularly, updates monthly. I'm not going to try to convince anyone to not do what they're doing. Hey, you know, if it's working, whatever you're doing is working. Weight Watchers, high fat, low calorie, high calorie, doesn't matter. If it's working for you, I'm with you all the way. I'm just doing something that's working for me, and it's working for me on my terms. And I don't feel deprived, and my skin looks pretty good. My face, you know, I can see the weight loss in my face. I can see it in my tummy. I can see it in my boobs. Oh, probably get demonetized. But yeah, I can see my weight loss. But and I have a very jolly face, so, you know, my face is not firm. It is droopy. So, trying to do face exercise just to kind of prevent it, but I don't know if that's going to work. I just know right now that health-wise, I am far healthier than I have been for the last several years. And I'm not talking about when I was fat. I'm talking about when I started to lose weight. I'm healthier now, blood work-wise. Heart rate, I'm healthier than I was in my keto days, in my pure low carb days. I'm healthier now. I feel it. And people around me are noticing it. And people around me are commenting. And these are people in my real life. So it's working for me. And that's my update. I'll do another one in a month. Maybe in a month from now, I'll have hit, 25 or whatever. Ultimately, my goal is 30. And I have not even really started to work out. I want to work out. I want to lift weights. I want to get myself back into some sort of a maybe spin class or get on that elliptical behind me, which I haven't gotten on in God knows how long. But anyway, so I'm rambling as usual. I hope I addressed your questions. I didn't stop doing keto because I'm against keto. I stopped doing keto because it didn't work for me. I stopped being a pure low carber because it didn't work for me ultimately. Meal replacements, nutritional balance, having good carbs, because I really believe not all carbs are bad, but having those good carbs and eating a more of a rounder nutritional program, balanced meal for me makes all the difference. So that's it, guys. I thank you so much for watching. I thank you so much all the time for all your support, all your comments, liking the video, supporting me, supporting the channel, and just being my friend. You guys are just awesome. You're all my friends, and I appreciate every single one of you. Bye, guys.